So the first method of GTD is obviously capturing. So if we look at the capture inbox here in my daily planner, every single time I have an idea, I have a few places where I can capture those ideas. If it's a task idea, then I will generally speaking put it in my daily planner under the capture inbox, which essentially has a function that has the created time here, and the filtering on this is the time is empty, the status is not complete, and created time is today. So what I'm doing here is I'm creating a spot for me to jot down any ideas for tasks that I can ever think of. And the reason that it's on my daily planner is because my daily planner is essentially a place that aggregates all of my planned out stuff into one day. This filtering here is where time is today and status is not checked off. Basically at the end of the day, same goes for the habits, by the way, and for my Rise Productive Hub. At the end of this day, we are going to have all this stuff checked off. And what we're doing here is aggregating information so it's easier for me to look at. And then another place that's where I capture stuff, because there's only really two things that I do, right? I either have a task or I have a content idea. And that content idea is essentially any type of video or podcast idea that I could have. So right now you can see I have, why do I use Notion, one tool versus many argument. This is another idea that I have, and I can quickly put what type of platform it's on and what tags I want on it here. And then this has a relation to my video project tracker, and it also has a relation to my podcast episode tracker. So when I use this content ideas database and this capture inbox consistently, what I'm doing is I'm taking all of my random ideas that occur, and rather than having them be put into just my brain and not into an actual physical database, it's preventing me from losing ideas from occurring. So I actually have two other places that I also capture. Now this is different than what a lot of people like to do, which is called the second brain, but I have something that's different. So I have like four preordained buckets, right? I have the capture inbox for tasks, content ideas for just whatever content ideas I have, and then I have something called system improvements and a journal. So system improvements is something that consistently just, I have a task that I move to the next week, I duplicate, get rid of what I did the week before, move to the next week. And this is essentially like just me jotting down for that section of time where I'm going to consistently try to improve my systems. And then for my journal, I mean, that thing is honestly just for getting ideas out on a day-to-day basis. It's for letting myself splurge anything that occurs. And if something comes out of this regarding a system improvement or a task, I'll then put it into one of those preordained buckets. Now, a lot of people would say maybe having a second brain is better and to have it all grouped up. It's very possible that that could be the case. I could organize all of these together by having one singular database that just has a bunch of different properties that filters it out. I'm aware of that. However, I'm currently liking the system that I have and the bucketing I have, and I may end up moving to a second brain system, but for now, I capture by having like four preordained buckets that kind of take the one step out of organizing it and just putting it all together at once. So regarding the clarification step, if we go here to task and event calendar, I have a capture inbox that isn't just filtered for today. It's filtered for, you know, in general, it's just where the time is empty and the status is not checked. Now, I actually think it could be nice if someone wants a system like this where it's like newer and older. So for example, if I took this one, it's like newer tasks. And then if we filter this guy too, and created time is within the past, let's say month, and then older tasks would be, if we take this filter off, and this kind of just has everything. So in this circumstance, we're kind of differentiating between what's at top of mind and what's something that I had earlier going on. And you can have a table view here, but I just don't think it's great. So I personally am just someone who likes list views. And in this circumstance, what I can have here is an organizational step that goes past this, where I, after I clarify what's in the capture inbox, and I can say what is this, what tags does it need to have? What template does it need to take part in? Because as you guys see, I have a bunch of different templates that can auto do a lot of tags. The organization step is in my plan week sessions. So essentially twice a week, what I'll do is, as you can see over here consistently on Thursdays and on Saturdays or Sundays, I have a plan week session. And essentially what I do here is I first go to my framework. Then if we do a little double Notion action here, I go to my framework. Since I can't show how I have a dual screen setup, what I'll do is I'll go to my calendar here, and essentially I have a bunch of pre-made templates for all of these tasks. And this template here on the right is a direct duplicate of what I have going on here. So I have it broken out into a couple different sections. So actually, I think I'll just do this one at a time. So first and foremost, you can see I have my whole week as an ideal week. This is not exactly what I do on a week to week basis. This is not like the exact ones. I have a mock-up one just for video purposes, right? But so I have my ideas regarding what I would like my week to look like if I could bucket my time exactly this way every single week. And if we go throughout this thing, we can see that it's pretty structured. There's a lot of different planning that goes along with it. And I have a Google Calendar that associates with it as well, so that I can quickly look at that, see what times I have for random tasks that have occurred. If I have to drop off my car like I'm doing later today, I had to move everything up 30 minutes so that I could make the time. But essentially, I just take this on one screen, take my task on event calendar on the other screen. And what I'll do is I will take all of these, right, and move it into the proper day of the week in Notion twice a week. And as you can see, the templates are set up so that there's Monday through Wednesday, Thursday through Friday, Saturday through Sunday. And then there's the weekly to-dos, which are these, and they're also on my framework. And the reason that they're different is because these aren't exactly like YouTube related completely, or I guess just content creation completely. I don't just do YouTube. But moving forward with that, any other extra time that I have, I will take stuff from the capture inbox. So for example, I have like a YouTube catch up. YouTube is just like a catch-all term for me at times. And this would be all stuff that gets put into the YouTube catch-up time. If I have extra time, I will take stuff from the capture inbox and organize it into when I'm going to do the task. So for me, reflection is the fourth step in GTD that's a little bit different. So I will, generally speaking, use system improvements as a reflection time. It tells me whether I need to look at that framework, right? And whether I need to delete a task, just do it, template it, automate it, or delegate it. It gives me that option to take the systems that I have in place and make improvements on what I need to get done. Because if you don't consistently do something like that, what you're gonna find is that a lot of the new ideas that you have coming forth aren't exactly great. Like they'll be good, but the implementation of those ideas will not occur unless you actually reflect on whether they're working. Like for example, I recently figured out, if we go to my framework, that it's better if I were to take my community posting time and task batch it with my writing social media content. Because it's like the same thing. Like I'm doing like the same brain sort of mindset of work, right? As well as scheduling social media content and scheduling YouTube community posts that are associated with a video. Because if I'm going to take the text from a YouTube community post and use it for a scheduled social media post regarding like, oh, hey, go check out my new video on this topic, why not just like have it copied on the clipboard and alt tab between the two platforms, between later.com, which I do for my scheduling of YouTube posts, and then just the YouTube community posting section. That is task batch better. System improvements gets me to that point. Now regarding engaging, this is the last step of GTD. And in GTD, what you have here is the actual engaging of it. And I have a priority system that's a little bit different than probably other people. First and foremost, I have everything set up at a certain time. And while that is really the case for most things, there are some times where random tasks will get put in there and I'll just plop it in there. But I have a task priority sort of set up. If you look here, if you go to task group, this is set up in a priority system. So work obviously comes first, side hustle comes second, exercise is third, housekeeping, tasks, scheduling and reflection, social, and then school is gone, but I like to have it here just for example purposes. This is obviously not always true regarding social. Sometimes if a family event comes up, that obviously takes precedent over anything in life. You gotta prioritize family or sometimes friends. And outside of that, I just use this as a priority-based system. Now, an extra layer that I could add on here, which I would recommend to anybody, would be if we add a property, make a status or a select property, sorry, priority. So for example, if I made a priority one and a priority two, what would be nice here is if I took this sorting feature and while the time is ascending and I can have also the task group as a secondary ascending, say for example, there was a housekeeping task on here. Obviously the side hustle stuff takes precedent over the housekeeping stuff. And then on top of that, I could also put a priority to where if it's priority one, then it would take precedent over something that's priority two, considering all these other factors. I like doing everything time-based. If you don't have the time aspect in here, this really changes things up. So I will do this. And as you can see, this drop-off car thing would change. I don't like that because obviously I need to drop off the car at 7:30. So that's why I don't do that. But to each is their own. And I think this is a setup that works well for me regarding the theoretical GTD here. And I like the life bucket aspect of things. But if you want to have a system that's like this, I would recommend checking out all my tutorials on how I make my different setup parts, how they are. And I have a bunch of different templates that can help you out. I'm probably at some point going to make an overall like huge system template. And I think that'll maybe be a paid one. Be out on the lookout for that if that's already posted by the time this video is out. I make videos 3 weeks in advance. And the last thing about the engage that I want to point out is at the end of the day, everything's checked off and disappears. As you can see here, every time I check something off, it's gone. I do the same thing for the habit tracking. And at the end of the day, nothing is on this page. I can, besides the journal here, and it's awesome because I can be like, okay, cool. Everything that I have on a day-to-day basis shows up when it needs to. And then when it's done, it's done.
So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you want to check out any of my other Notion tutorials, please make sure to hit the end screen playlist up above. And with that being said, we'll see you guys in the next one.